Oh, hey boys and girls, it's Mike here again. One go shortly. This morning we are playing Aladdin on the NES. Surely this is going to be good. The Mega Drive version of this was fantastic. It's got the same intro music, not as well done, but of course it's an 8-bit machine. I wouldn't expect it to be. It looks like a Mega Drive though. It looks like the same, you know, general design, but with lower graphics quality. I'm happy with that. I was just pondering on the last game. That's a good start. It's a good start. Right, it's got the colour limitations, but they're well handled. Okay. Oh dear, and then the similarity ends. You can jump, and you can throw apples. You can't use your sword. Oh, right. Oh, and that jump's awful. It's that thing, there's no... This is where there being no inertia doesn't work. See? The animation's nice. Oh, God. Oh, that's a little luggish. So if you hold the button down for a couple of seconds, it's fine. If you double tap, but hold it down for a while, you get this weird, very slowly animated jump at the end. And the jump, or the Mega Drive version. You tap the Mega Drive version, it jumps a little bit. You hold it down, it jumps as long as you hold it down, up to a point. You know, the usual rules of jumping in a 2D platformer. This is horrible. So they've got all the ingredients, the graphics are there. The artists have done their job. This is a really bad port for the Mega Drive version. I mean, a really bad port. It's a lazy port, code line. Yeah, so it doesn't have the work into the controls. But of course, in screenshots, it would look good. So it would sell. Because back then, you had magazines to tell you how good the game was. And even if you didn't believe the review, even if the review was bad, you didn't have to believe it. You could look at the screenshots and go, actually, it's beautiful. The animations are all there. Well done, artists. Programmers, what were you thinking? On these, that there's no like this to go off. Okay. Let's stop our whinging. It's Aladdin. Let's enjoy it. It's got the music from the film. It's got the graphics. What more do you want? Stop whinging, Mike. I know what you want. You want the gameplay that we were promised by the Mega Drive version. What I am pleased about is, I think this, if I remember rightly, and I might not, the SNES version isn't a faithful conversion of the Mega Drive version. It doesn't have to be. It's, you know, Nintendo are loyal to themselves when it comes to this sort of thing. And we can do if we want. So, throw apples. We've only got 14 apples left anyway. How do you use your sword? It can't be a way. It's a genius. It's a genius. Yeah, the Mega Drive version makes me want to sing the songs. This version just feels like a bit of a not very good version of the songs. Am I even hitting it? There's no feedback. Yeah, you don't often hear it said, but the Sega version just takes chunks out of this version. That said, it might be the Master System version, you know, that wasn't faithful to the Mega Drive version. So Sega's own 8-bit versions might be a bit rubbish. This reminds me, however, of the 8-bit versions of Strider, which on the Mega Drive and on the arcade are lovely, because the Mega Drive version feels like the arcade version, but on all the other versions, which were done by someone else, I'm sure it's Tertex or someone who aren't really known for great things, no offense to Tertex, which is the way it is, I'm sure there's a few buttons there. Yeah, those versions of Strider felt like this, kind of floaty, no inertia, in a game that really benefits from inertia, and no sense that it feels like the original, you know, game that's emulating. This is a port of the Mega Drive version, and as such, it's got a lot to live up to, but they've totally missed the things that made the Mega Drive version good. It just goes to show that even having the animations in, doesn't a good game make. Just the gameplay's being bundled. It's going at about 12 frames a second for a start. It doesn't have any of the kind of viscerality of the Mega Drive version. You know, it's not. I was hoping I could just cheat there because I'm not going to wait back, but apparently I am. That's nice. That works for that. There you go. Good. Mega Drive version. Then you stop. Or you try and do something else. Good job. It does feel like the version started. And I never liked those really. I mean, I liked them on the Spectrum because it was all I had. And I knew the arcade version on the Spectrum version. But I knew that it wasn't a touch on the arcade version. And this feels like that. I'd be disappointed with this if I bought it. I think the NES is capable of much better than this. With the Aladdin license as well, I think it's really fun. A good job of this. I mean, with the game that was already there, the Aladdin game that already exists, just building on that, they could have done this really well. It just feels like the programmer wasn't up to the job. It just really does. Oh, come on. That way then. We'll just cut out the death animation. We don't need any feedback to tell the player that they've just lost all their life. They'll be watching their energy bar. I didn't watch my energy bar at all, by the way. Neither did I watch my energy bar in the Mega Drive version. But you do expect some sort of feedback when you die. It's not a good thing to see death animation. Oh, really? But you do expect it. Because, well, it's a game, isn't it? It needs its animation. Oh, I don't like this. I was just thinking about the last game I was playing. Al Murray's racing cars. I can't remember what it's called. Anyone else with me on this? I did find. Being, you know, that I was the target audience for games, 16-bit games in particular, and 8-bit games in the early 90s, late 80s, early 90s, I did find that sticking a celebrity's name to a game had the opposite effect to what the developers or the publishers of said game expected, and it made me less inclined, in fact not inclined, to buy the game, because I didn't want an experience associated with someone that wanted the game to be good on its own merits. Does that make sense? Because it was a really potent thing, wasn't it? I'm trying to give examples, I don't know. Yeah, Ayrton Senna, Super Mario 2, wasn't it? When they put Ayrton Senna's name on Super Mario Grand Prix 2. That, for me, cheapened the Super Mario license. Surely that's the opposite of what they'd expect. Surely they were expecting or hoping that by sticking the name of a big Formula 1 star on the game, it would validate the game and, you know, give it, I guess, an authenticity that it's been unlucky with. Endorsed, that's the word, not for your shot. Alright, let me out. What's the deal? Right. So that's just. I don't want more gems. That was unintuitive. Again, I'm sure the Mega Drive version just, you know, just made that shopkeeper really smooth. A really smooth spawn. That's a checkpoint, isn't it? Spawn point. Oops. But, yeah. Like that Al thingies, Al Murray's racing cars game. I don't know who that Al thingy junior was. Well, it sounds like to me he was trying to raise his profile by attaching himself to a game. Quite the opposite of what he was trying to do, surely, which was raising the game's profile by attaching it to a famous driver. Gamers aren't necessarily interested in the sports that the games are about. They're interested in the quality of the emulation of the sport. This level was really hard on my mind. It feels like the kind of bad controls on this one make this level a bit easier to kind of float through. It's not a great version. So, Jimmy, And again, I'm finding the opposite argument here. People are saying that the NES had all the great games and the Sega devices didn't. I beg to differ. I mean, alright, I'm comparing this with the Mega Drive, and that's probably a bad idea. I should be comparing this with the Master System, and maybe that would be right. This version is probably better than the Master System, which is, if I remember rightly, oh look, I've got a sword. Excuse my laughter. That's a bit of a weird word to do. I'd rather use the sword most of the time. Then again, the sword is really ineffective in this version. Suddenly he's not using his apple. Okay, whatever. I was not suppressing. Yeah, so maybe I should be comparing this version. Can't hit and jump at the same time. That has just made the problems. Starts to feel a little bored in this version. A little frustrated. It's definitely not fun. This is silly. The platform's been ruined by the awful mechanic. It's horrible. But I mean, what a waste of animation. It makes me feel that the animation's been wasted. That feels like Stride on Spectre. Yeah, no, damn, there's no secret to tell me that because you can't be bothered. It feels like a whole jar full that can't be bothered. Give some apples, I'm sick of the sword, it's ineffective. Not, that's it. The sword. The apples suddenly don't work anymore. Really? The apples? Oh, there you go. Oh, select. Okay. Now, I suppose that makes sense, there's only two buttons. Yeah, the sword's really ineffective. It's challenging, just in different ways to the Mega Drive version, and those ways aren't very fun. That's the problem. First rule of thumb within a game, I suppose, is it fun? If it's not fun, you're in trouble, aren't you? I wonder when you'd go off and if you were like, hey, I'm having fun. I don't know. I'm just like, I can't even be bothered fighting with the pirate. I just can't, I'd rather take the hit. So I'm not going to get very far with that attitude, am I? Uh-oh. Check it. Where's my attention? Yeah, and I was just thinking about that car game thing. Yeah, I don't know. I wouldn't have bought it based on the name of the person associated with it. And I think it can't just be me. There's got to be a lot of games that wouldn't have it. I know a lot of people did. What happened to the checkpoints? I know a lot of people did buy Nintendo's Super Mario Bros. 2 because it was an Nintendo game. But I wonder how much that affected the sales of the game. Would it last so more? If then this is rubbish. There's no precision to it. I keep thinking of Stride on the Spectre. Which, to be honest, I like more than this. Although I've been booked for the online, I think because I expected less of Stride on the Spectre. I expected more of Aladdin on the NES. Especially when I saw that it was an attempt at putting Mega Drive version, which I never would have expected initially, to be honest. But that was immediately tainted by disappointment. Come on, Yago. Oh, and then animates, really? Nah, that was pack. Aladdin for the NES. Thanks for watching.